Welcome to Philippine Canadian Inquirer's Daily News Roundup, brought to you by CanadianInquirer.net, your only Filipino-Canadian daily news portal. I'm Rowan Echo, and here are stories making headlines today. Duterte defends dictatorial style of governance. The only way for the Philippines to prosper is to have an autocratic style of governance, President Rodrigo Duterte said while admitting that he is a dictator. Speaking before former communist rebels in Malacañang, the president said, quote, "If you say dictator, well, I am really a dictator," unquote. He adds that there is a need to be one because if he would not implement a tough governance, nothing will happen to the country. Moreover, Duterte slammed his critics, labeling him as a puppet of the United States, saying such accusation is impossible because he does not even want to interact with Americans. ICC to conduct preliminary examination versus Duterte and Philippines war on drugs. The Hague-based International Criminal Court is set to conduct its preliminary examination on the alleged summary executions related to President Rodrigo Duterte's campaign to suppress the narcotics problem in the Philippines. Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque confirmed on Thursday, February 8, in a palace briefing. Quote, "Our mission in The Hague was informed that the Office of the Prosecutor of the International Criminal Court is opening a preliminary examination on the alleged acts associated with the campaign against illegal drugs covering the period of July 2016, unquote, Roque said in a palace briefing. The spokesman, however, clarified that the intent of preliminary examination is to determine whether there is a reasonable basis to proceed with an investigation and is different from the preliminary investigation. Quote, "The Office of the Prosecutor is merely exercising his mandate to determine whether there is a reasonable basis to proceed with an investigation into a situation pursuant to the criteria in the Rome Statute, namely jurisdiction, admissibility, and interests of justice," unquote, Roque said. With military parade, Kim Jong Un thumbs nose at U.S. North Korean leader Kim Jong Un presided over an extravagant military parade in Pyongyang's Kim II Sung Square on a Thursday, grabbing the spotlight on the eve of the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics in South Korea to thumb his nose at Washington while making a point of showing off his newfound restraint towards Seoul. The parade itself had been anticipated for weeks. North Korea announced last month that it would hold a big event to mark the 70th anniversary of the founding of its military. But instead of broadcasting the morning event live, North Korean television aired an edited version later in the day, giving it a somewhat lower profile than expected. The parade was also shorter and featured fewer missiles than the previous one, which was held in April last year and unveiled five new kinds of missiles, surprising analysts and generating headlines worldwide. This time, Kim fine-tuned his more fiery rhetoric toward Washington. Addressing tens of thousands of troops and civilians assembled on the square below him, Kim said the parade marks North Korea's emergence as a global military power despite facing the worst sanctions. He called for his military to maintain a high level of combat readiness against the United States and its followers to keep them from infringing upon the Republic's sacred dignity and autonomy, even by 1 millimeter. He made no mention of the Olympics in the parts of his speech that were broadcast. It was unclear whether the North showed the entirety of his speech during the recorded coverage of the parade. That wraps up our news here on PZI Daily News Roundup. Thank you for joining us. For more news stories, visit our website at www.canadianinquirer.net.